Flaccid paralysis. Acute flaccid paralysis is a clinical syndrome characterized by rapid onset of weakness, progressing to maximum severity within days to several days to weeks. And the term flaccid means or refers to absence of spasticity, or absence of other UMN signs. And AFP, acute flaccid paralysis AFP, is defined as any case of acute flaccid paralysis in children less than 15 years old or any paralytic illness at any age when polio is suspected. So, 2 points you have to remember, that is any case of acute flaccid paralysis in children less than 15 years old or any paralytic illness at any age when polio is suspected. Common causes of acute flaccid paralysis include Guillain-Barré syndrome, poliomyelitis, transverse myelitis, traumatic neuritis, and post diphtheric neuropathy, non polio enterovirus illnesses. And in 27th March 2014, WHO declared India a polio-free country in 2015. Then, so once again about the differential diagnosis of acute flaccid paralysis in detail. So they can be divided as one as muscle disorders, second, neuromuscular junction disorders, third, neuropathies, fourth, anterior horn cell disorders, and fifth, spinal cord disease. So first one, muscle disorders, that include inflammatory myopathy, periodic paralysis, that is hypokalemic periodic paralysis, hypokalemia, infections. Next, neuromuscular junction disorders, and that include myasthenia gravis, botulism, and Eaton-Lambert syndrome. Then Third, neuropathies. It include GBS, Guillain-Barré syndrome, traumatic neuritis. Post diphtheric neuropathy, porphyria, vasculitis. Then anterior horn cell disorder. And that include our poliomyelitis and non-polio enteroviruses. Next, spinal cord disease. And that include transverse myelitis, spinal cord compression, trauma. Now let's see acute flaccid paralysis surveillance, AFP surveillance. And this include that is this is under the polio eradication initiative and is the chief strategy to screen for circulating wild polio virus in the post polio eradication era. All patients with acute flaccid paralysis within the last 6 months should be reported to surveillance medical officers. So within the last 6 months should be reported to the surveillance medical officer. And other conditions that require notifications are, so those conditions which has to be notified are, one, we told acute flaccid paralysis within the last 6 months. Second, isolated facial palsy. Then isolated bulbar palsy. Then unproven hypokalemia. Neck flop, that is it can indicate the flaccid paralysis, and floppy baby, and flaccid hemiplegia, encephalitis, postictal weakness, and post diphtheric polyneuritis. So these conditions we have to notify to the surveillance medical officer of WHO. And surveillance is done in major 4 steps. So 4 steps in surveillance. They are, first, finding and reporting children with AFP. Second, transporting stool. Stool sample for analysis. Third, isolating polio virus in laboratory. Fourth, mapping the virus. To determine its origin. These cases are immediately investigated within 48 hours of notification. So, any cases of acute flaccid paralysis should be investigated within 48 hours. That is investigated by a trained medical officer. After confirming the case as acute flaccid paralysis, the investigator takes medical history and conducts examination and proceeds with other aspects of case investigation, including collection and transportation of stool specimens for laboratory testing, search for additional cases, and outbreak investigation in the affected community. About the stool specimens. Two stool specimens are collected. Ideally within 14 days of paralysis. And at least 24 hours apart. And while the optimal period of for detection of polio virus in the stool is within 14 days of onset of paralysis, specimens may be collected from any late reported cases up to 60 days from the onset of paralysis. And beyond 60 days after paralysis, the likelihood of detecting polio virus is very low. Voided stool specimen is preferred. In cases where it is not possible, for example, if the child has constipation or died, digital extraction has to be done, or postmortem stool collection to be done from the contents of large intestine, and also we can use rectal tube, and enema or purgatives are not recommended. Each specimen should be 8 gram each. And about the size of an adult thumb. This should be collected in a clean, dry, screw-capped container, and the specimens are collected, labeled, and then transported in the cold chain. And two types of cell lines are used for poliovirus isolation. That is, human rhabdomyosarcoma cell lines, it favor all enteroviruses, and one is this, and second is L20B cell lines, and it is only for polioviruses. And a case is classified as polio if wild polio virus is isolated from the stool specimen. So, if the wild polio virus is isolated from the stool specimen, then that case is classified as polio. Cases with inadequate stool specimens and having residual weakness who have died or are lost to follow-up undergo additional investigation and are presented for review by National Expert Review Committee. This committee classifies the case as compatible with polio or compatible with polio or discarded as non-polio AFP.